But you only need the light when it's burning low. Only miss the sun when it starts to snow. Only know you love her when you let her go.
Let Her Go is the poetic tune by Passenger, aka Mike Rosenberg, that reached number one here in Australia and around the world.
Oh, if you go, I'll go, as long as you want me to stay.
Along the way, Mike's toured with his pal Ed Sheeran.
Oh, darling, my heart's on fire.
Who helped him go from playing on street corners to stadiums, introducing him to a new legion of fans everywhere he went.
Nice and loud, man. Oh, life's for the living, so we better hope.
Passenger's latest album is called Songs for the Drunk and Brokenhearted, and it's out tomorrow. Unless, of course, he's too drunk and brokenhearted.
Inside man sings a song for the drunk and brokenhearted. And fool, he never knows how much it costs.
Passenger, welcome to the project. Now, you were actually due to tour Australia any day now, but that whole pandemic thing put a bit of a stop to that. Is releasing an album just as good as touring?
Yeah, it's a different thing. I mean, obviously, everything this year and last year has been kind of thrown up into the air, and usually we release an album and sort of tour simultaneously. So it's a strange process just to release music and kind of sit around with my cats this time. But yeah, it's still lovely to do something creative.
Your new album is called Songs for the Drunk and Brokenhearted and was inspired, not surprisingly, by a breakup. And now, of course, everyone gets to hear it. Did you actually call and run it past the ex first?
Yeah. It's a sort of boardroom situation where I have all of my ex-girlfriends there just to discuss whether they're happy with things. You know, we're still really good friends and still in touch and stuff. So. You know, I think she's cool with it all. I just really felt like people haven't been through enough misery and heartbreak this year. I thought I'd dump some more sort of depressing, melodramatic ballads on them just to see how they'd cope with it.
Well, how do you keep coming up with new material? I mean, do you just have to keep having terrible breakups? What's the method? Yeah,
that's exactly right. I get into relationships and then I purposefully mess them up so we can break up, and then I've got another album.
Oh.
So, no, I'm joking.
It sounds like you're even sadder than your listeners.
I'm the saddest one of all.
Yep.
Yeah.
Have you ever thought of hooking up with Taylor Swift? Because between you, the song Misery would just be epic.
Hooking up in a musical sense, I presume.
Well, whatever works for you, Mike.
I love her new record. I think it's absolutely brilliant. Yeah, so, well, Taylor, if you're watching, let's duet sometime, sure.
Mike, can I just check it? At least tell me that you only write breakup songs about people who broke up with you, not people who you broke up with. Otherwise, you're just rubbing salt in the wound.
I couldn't possibly comment or go into detail on that stuff. But, you know, the breakup thing, it's funny, isn't it? The breakup thing, I mean, I know I'm not the first singer-songwriter to sort of harness the emotion that comes out of a breakup. And I think the reason is, like, that's what people... You know, everyone goes through breakups. And not everybody can write songs about it. If you look at popular music, so many massive songs over the years have been about this subject matter. And I think it's because people, when they're in that situation, music speaks to you in a different way when you're going through something like that. So songs about this subject really are quite important to get everybody through those experiences, I think.
I promise you we can all relate. Passenger's new album, Songs for the Drunk and Brokenhearted, is out tomorrow, and details for his Royal Albert Hall performance, streaming this weekend, are on our website. Mike Rosenberg, thank you for the music and thank you for the chat. Take care.
It's been a real pleasure. Thanks for your time.
Hey there. Thanks for watching. Carrie loves to hear from viewers. Please forward your feedback to Carrie's email, perth.girl/21@hotmail.com, and be sure to subscribe. That wasn't Carrie you heard off screen.